That just fell on me tonight, and we're going to talk about that and see what's going on. I'm interested to see what's in Zechariah, the third chapter. I'm interested to see what's in Zechariah. Y'all interested to see what's in Zechariah, the third chapter?
Yes.
Amen. Because y'all know what's coming now. It's fresh bread. It's fresh bread is coming now. Amen. So get ready. Get ready for the fresh bread. Y'all hungry for some fresh bread? Is the fat five ready for the fresh bread?
Fresh bread.
Hallelujah, Zechariah 3 and 1. I don't hear one person get excited on that. Everybody just smile. What's up with that? Y'all give God, come on, give God some praise for the fresh bread. Fresh bread. Hallelujah, glory to God. Woo! Glory to God. Zechariah, the third chapter, if you have that, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. 3 and 1, it says, and he showed me Joshua, the high priest, standing before the angel of the Lord, and Satan standing at his right hand to resist him. And the Lord said unto Satan, the Lord rebuke thee, O Satan, even the Lord that has chosen Jerusalem, rebuke thee. Is not this a brand plucked out of the fire? Now Joshua was clothed with filthy garments, and stood before the angel. And he answered and spake unto those that stood before him, saying, take away the filthy garments from him. And unto him he said, behold, I have caused thine iniquity to pass from thee, and I will clothe thee with change of raiment. And I said, let them set a fair meter upon his head. So they set a fair meter upon his head and clothed him with garments, and the angel of the Lord stood by. And the angel of the Lord protested unto Joshua, saying, thus saith the Lord of hosts, if thou wilt walk in my ways, and if thou wilt keep my charge, then thou shalt also judge my house, and shalt also keep my courts. And I will give thee places to walk among these that stand by. Hear now, O Joshua, the high priest, thou and thy fellows that sit before thee, for they are men wondered at. For behold, I will bring forth my servant the branch. For behold, the stone that I have laid before Joshua upon one stone shall be seven eyes. Behold, I will engrave the graving thereof, saith the Lord of hosts, and I will remove the iniquity of that land in one day. In that day, saith the Lord of hosts, shall ye call every man his neighbor under the vine and under the fig tree. Look at your neighbor and say, it is time.
It is time
to change clothes.
To change clothes.
It's time.
It's time
to change clothes.
Change clothes.
One more time. It's time.
It is time
to change
clothes.
Hallelujah. It's time to change clothes, y'all. Amen. Hallelujah. So we have a distinct picture here. We got Joshua the high priest. He's representing Jerusalem at this time, okay? Amen. Praise God. He is literally in the inner courtroom or in the courtroom of glory right now. Okay? Now, what he's doing there, he's standing in proxy for Jerusalem. The high priest is mediating for Jerusalem. If Joshua is there in filthy clothes, okay, being protected, because Satan was there to resist him. You see that? You see the activity when you go into prayer, how Satan presents himself to stop you or to even accuse you. Did you catch that? He's there to stop you or even accuse you. Joshua is representing Jerusalem before the courtroom of glory. You, because Christ died on the cross, have this same spot in the courtroom of glory. You are right there in the presence of God when you go into prayer. This is how serious, y'all, this is how serious prayer is. It's just not, see, so physically, we might be in our house, in our room, in our car. But the minute you open up the door of prayer, you just stepped into a whole new dimension. Into a whole new dimension. For real. Don't let your surroundings fool you from the power you have inside of you. Don't let your surroundings fool you from the power you have inside of you. Satan will be there to resist you from opening up that door of prayer. Okay? He will be there to resist you because he knows it's your time to change clothes. And you ain't going to be changing your own clothes. You're not going to be the one that's going to disrobe you. Oh, I glory to God, man! You have a wardrobe assistant waiting on you. A wardrobe assistant waiting on you to help you get out of the filthy garments and then get clothed in this righteous garment that God has set aside for you. And so Joshua, he's representing all the sins that Jerusalem is doing. And he's bringing them before God. Hallelujah, glory to God. And Satan doesn't want him to intercede for Jerusalem. Because Jerusalem has been chosen, as a chosen nation, has been chosen out to lead the nation in precept and example through commandments and precepts and honor to show the world what kind of God the Lord is. Israel was chosen as a chosen nation to reveal the precepts and the glorious laws of Jesus Christ and of God to a Gentile nation. That's why the Jews are the apples of God's eye. And that's why God, what did he do? God reserved the covenant for Jerusalem, okay? He reserved the covenant for them. He kept us on the outskirts for a while until Jesus came and broke down that middle wall of partition. We talked about that in Galatians, praise God, where he became a curse for us. Remember that? That Jesus Christ became a curse for us, that the blessings of Abraham, amen, praise God, may come upon the Gentiles. So he lifted up the curse, justified us in the sight of God, and now he made us a joint heir with him. So everything that Abraham gets for the children of Israel, we now have access to already. It is ours because we are a joint heir. We are a joint heir of God.